we are devoted to the scriptures, we are devoted to prayer, but one of the things we are devoted to is fellowship. So a wonderful time indeed to fellowship. I hope you're looking forward to just this time of worship and fellowship and prayer. So amen. I'm gonna start tonight with a word of prayer. Welcome, my brothers and sisters. It's good to see everybody. Let's bow down our heads to pray. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, God, we stand in awe of your love. Heavenly Father, we stand accused by the evil one all the time. But Father, you have given us everything we need, dear God, to stand. And yes, you always want us to be aware of what's of our surroundings, because sometimes when we think we are standing and then we don't know that the evil one is busy working on our downfall. We thank you so much, dear God, for your grace and mercy. We praise your holy name. We worship you with our lives. We worship you with our service. We worship you, dear God, with our hearts, with our minds, with our thoughts, and everything we have. Thank you so much, dear Heavenly Father, for just the wonderful nature we see around us. Thank you so much for the beauty we see, Father, the mountains. We see the beautiful blue skies, dear God, the snow-white clouds, Heavenly Father, the beautiful animals we see, Father, the phenomenon of a lion, dear God, is just mind-blowing. I mean, just to think that lion can't see color, Father, just to think that how fast and how big the thing is and how fast it is. Father, it is incredible to see your nature. Just a human being, dear God, and the fact that there is voice that, and we can interpret voice, dear God, through our ears and our brain, dear God, and just the functionality of a human being, it's so intricate. Father, the more the scientists study human body, the more we discover so much, dear God. And we praise you, dear God, for the science. We praise you, dear Heavenly Father, for the technology. We praise you, dear God, for just blessing us, just for love, your comfort, dear God, for your patience, Heavenly Father, because if it wasn't for your patience, we would not be here. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for tonight. Dear God, we are going through an incredible phase as the world's history, dear God. I pray, Father, for this COVID, that one day we will see the back of it, dear Heavenly Father. I pray, my dear God, that you will be with our brothers and sisters who've lost their loved ones, that you continue, dear God, to comfort them, dear God. Mina lost her brother, dear God. We pray that you will comfort the family. We pray that you will, Father, just be with Mina, dear God, as she goes home to be with her family. I pray, my Father, that you will be with them. You will walk with her, dear God, that she will shine the light wherever she goes, dear God, to be with the family. I pray for Branette, dear Heavenly Father, and may it be that, God, you perform this miracle for us, that one day Branette will be here with us, fellowshipping with us, as strong as we know him, dear God. We pray so much, dear God, that you will strengthen us, all of us, as a church, dear God. Father, we have survived the worst, dear Heavenly Father. But God, we know, Father, that these are incredibly difficult times. And so I pray, my Father, that truly just give us the courage and the strength to stand, dear God. I pray that you will continue to protect us, dear Father. I pray that you will continue to give us everything we need, dear God, to survive these times, dear God. Father, I pray that tonight will be an awesome time of worship. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen, Church of Christ. Please join in song today. We are testing out how the singing is going to work. We haven't done this before. I've got my people here behind me, backing me. You may not see them, but we are distancing here so that you know, we keep to the protocols of social distance. Amen. So let's sing. Our first song will be, Fill me, Lord, with your spirit and make me like a leader who has a strong army. Fill me, my Lord. Fill me, Lord, with your spirit and make me like a leader who leads a strong army. Fill me, my Lord, I pray. Oh Lord, I'm just man. Oh, I need your power to guide me, dear Lord. I need your spirit to guide me. Fill me, my Lord, I pray. Oh Lord, I'm just a man. Oh, I need your power to guide me, dear Lord. I need your spirit to guide me. Fill me, my Lord, I pray. Lord, prepare me to be a living sanctuary, to be tried and true. Fill me, my Lord, I pray. Oh Lord, I'm just a man. Oh, I need your power to guide me, dear Lord. I need your spirit to guide me. Fill me, my Lord, I pray. Oh Lord, I'm just a man. Oh, I need your power to guide me, dear Lord. I need your spirit to guide me. Fill me, my Lord, I pray. Oh, Lord, I'm just a man. Oh, I need your power to guide me, dear Lord. I need your spirit to guide me, fill me, oh my Lord, I pray. I'm just a man. Oh, I need your power to guide me, dear Lord. I need your spirit to guide me, fill me, oh my Lord, I pray. Oh Lord, I'm just a man. Oh, I need your power to guide me, dear Lord. I need your spirit to guide me. Fill me, my Lord, I pray. Amen. Jesu, kiena wamatomo. Jesu kie na wama fele lo kia fale o kiri. Jesu kie na, Jesu kie na wama fele lo kia fale kiri. Jesu kie na, Jesu kiena ewa ma vele woki afa hey ruri ruri kiena Jesu kiena ewa ma vele eki afa Jesu kiafa Le omera ke afa le omera Jesu ke afa le omera Jesu ke afa le omera Jesu, Jesu kiena, Jesu kiena, ewa ma pele e kiafa. Ruri, ruri kiena, Jesu kiena, ewa ma pele e kiafa. Jesu kiena, Jesu kiena, ewa ma pele e kiafa le omera. Jesu kiafa le o, Jesu kiafa le omera. Jesu kiafa le omera le o Jesu kiafa le omera Jesu kiafa le omera Amen Amen His name is Jesus, oh, Jesus. Jesus in the morning, Jesus in the noontime. Jesus, oh, Jesus. Jesus till the sun goes down. His name is Jesus, oh, Jesus. Come on now, Jesus in the morning. Jesus in the new, his name is Jesus, oh, Jesus, Jesus till the sun goes down, why don't you love him, oh, love him in the morning, love him in the noontime, love him, oh, sister, love him, love him till the sun goes down. Why don't you praise him? Oh, praise him in the morning, oh, in the noontime. Praise him, my brother, praise him. Praise him till the sun goes down. Cause his name is Jesus, oh, Jesus. Come on now, Jesus in the morning. In the new time, Jesus, come on, oh Jesus, 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 till the sun goes down. Why don't you love him? Oh, love him in the morning, in the new time, love him. Oh, yeah, come on now, love him till the sun goes down. Come on and pray. Praise him, oh, praise him in the morning, praise him in the noontime, praise him, oh, praise him till the sun goes up. Oh, sit him, bonge, yeah, bonge, bonge, egusene, bonge, nasemini. Bonge, yebo, bonge, lize lishone langa,
Haungi tim tane, tane, tane eguseni, tane nasemini, tane, oh, tane, lize lishoni langa, his name is Jesus, oh, Jesus. Jesus in the morning, Jesus in the noontime, Jesus, oh, Jesus, Jesus till the sun goes down.
Thank you so much, Baba Andrew and the band, Sistoy and Ronald and Paul. Thank you so much for leading us in worship. I thought that was awesome. It was exciting, and I hope in your rooms or homes, wherever you are on Zoom, really got into the worship. And this in one step closer to a live service, God willing, and the church says amen. Well, today we're going to talk about prayer. We'll continue with the lesson that Temba did on Sunday. And at this time, I would like to have two people share. About a few weeks back, the campus ministry here in Suwannee decided to do a prayer at 5:30 in the morning till 6 in the morning for a whole week. So as you can imagine, that's pretty up. That's an upward call. And so I'm going to have Abigail and Moses share about that with us. Before they do, I just want to introduce Abigail. Maybe a lot of you might already know her. She's from the Mamelodi Church of Christ, but she's actually in Ukraine. And she is serving the campus ministry here in Suwannee, even though she's all the way in Ukraine. And she does a great job, just has an amazing heart for the Lord. And Moses, I'm sure a lot of you know Moses. He has a job. He works 8 to 5, and he's sharing how he would like to give back to the campus ministry. So he's a unpaid volunteer campus intern. So the rest, that's what he does, and he does a great job. Just appreciate their partnership in the gospel. And so at this time, I'll have Abigail share, and after her, Moses is going to share. Go ahead, Abby.
Oh, thank you. Good evening, everyone. Like Uncle Raj said, my name is Abigail. I am initially from the Mamelodi Church of Christ, but I'm currently in Ukraine. So it's so awesome that I get to be here with you guys virtually. Super exciting. So I'm going to share very shortly just about the prayer challenge that we did a few weeks back. Uncle Raj already mentioned we did 5:30 to 6 every single day for a week, Monday to Sunday. We were asked how long a week is. Yes, a full 7 days. So I'm just going to share why we did it, what stood out for me. So the idea of it was to kind of refocus, realign ourselves, get ourselves ready for the educational school year. So before everyone was going back to varsity, just to kind of meet together and be able to be united in prayer. And so obviously the first thing I'd like to say was just unity, connection, and vulnerability. So I think praying is something really personal. It's like literally you communicating with God, your like deepest thoughts and like what's on your heart. So I think being able to be open with each other. And I think when you pray, it's easy to pray what everyone expects you to pray or say whatever you think people expect you to say. But after doing that for a week, you kind of get to see what's really on a person's heart because you can see what they pray for every single day. So I think that stood out for me and just being able to, I think also just see how people grew where on the Monday when we started, it was like, oh, this is awkward. I don't know what to say. I don't like praying out loud. And then by the Sunday, we were doing like 5-minute long prayers and we like had a problem getting people to pray shorter so that we didn't run out of time. So that was really cool. And I think I already mentioned that, but just realigning our focus for the year. So yes, it was like 3 months into the year, but we had just started our educational year. So I think just to bring that to God as a campus ministry, to go to God with our plans for what the campus ministry, what we wanted that to look like, our plans for education, our plans for personal goals as well. And I think just to bring that to God. And I think also just to like find his peace in the midst of the chaos as well. And then lastly, which I think the biggest thing was just the challenge. I am not a morning person, so it was so challenging for me to wake up every single day at 5:30. And what I loved was, again, just vulnerability, where a lot of the campus students shared, like, this is not something I want to do, like, for fun, to be up at this time, but amen. So to see everyone's hearts and willingness to get up, and even, like, someone asked me, oh, will you please text me to wake me up? So I was like, awesome, let's do that. Let's, like, encourage each other. Like, it's not easy for all of us. So yeah, being up at 5:30, and then also consistency. I loved seeing people there more than one day, or some people were there the entire week, which I found super encouraging. So that's just what stood out for me. And yeah.
Thank you very much, Abby. I'll share next, but before I go on, I can quickly give it a quick background. So when we started this year, we sat down as campus and we were kind of evaluating what we did last year. So we were trying to see what did we do right, and we could take from that and apply this year, and what we could do better. And one thing that came up in that sitting was consistency. So we said, how can we take that and apply it into one thing this year? And as we were brainstorming, one thing that came up was prayer. And we chose to take prayer and be consistent in prayer this year. That turned out to be the theme for our campus group. So as we were brainstorming, we were looking for ways how we're going to live out this loud in our group. And just last month, before campus started, there was a suggestion that how about we meet every day and pray as a group? And this is how this came about. And because we are a campus group, young people, and we love to be up so early in the morning, we chose to wake up every day at 5:30 and just go to God in prayer. I think the reason, as Abby mentioned, there was just to pray for school in general, to pray for students' well-being and finances. As we saw around the time that campus started, that this was an issue of historical debt. Many of our students just in our group and outside our group, they were concerned that they might not be having school because of this issue. So we were praying around that. And we also, another reason was for us to be united as one, as we were taking these requests to God intentionally daily. And I can say that I think this period of time as we were praying, it helped us to be intentional in spending time together as a group with God first before anything that we did in the day, before our day could go on. This is what we did. And also, as Abigail mentioned, it made us connect, come closer and get to know each other better. But I would say personally, I learned from how everybody prayed, the vulnerability part, as Abby mentioned. I got to hear everyone's cry out prayer, so I could take that people's issues, personal issues, and pray for them even after that. And one thing that was encouraging from this period is to see the students that finally got to get into school without the finance being an issue. That for us, that was an answered prayer. And just to I think this was a period that made it easy to ease into our quiet time. The moment we wake up early and pray, it's easy to just ease into your quiet time. So from that day, we decided that maybe we should default a day, at least one day in a week, where we get together and pray. I thank Anchorage for allowing me to share. I hope this encourages you as we pray together and we pray for each other, especially in these difficult times. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Abby. Thank you, Moses, for such powerful sharing. I must just uplift the young people, the campus ministry, each one of them. I just appreciate their heart. You know, it's an upward call, and they really do swim upstream. And to see their commitment and their desire and their young, innocent faith, I think that's what really is a blessing, to have young people who are on fire for Christ, who are striving hard. They fall, they pick back up. They, you know, it's being young and being a follower of Christ is exciting, but also uniquely challenging. And they really do choose a life outside of what most of young people do. And so I just wanted to uplift them. And as a community, I pray that we can uplift them and honor them in the decision to follow Christ, even at such a young age. So hopefully this inspires you. You know, to be up at 5:30 to 6 and to pray is an upward call by you know, for all, not just young people. But hopefully this inspires you in your small groups to say, hey, maybe we should try something. You know, and maybe if it's not 5:30 a.m. to 6 a.m., maybe it's 5:30 p.m. to 6 p.m. So, but the idea is we're meeting, we're praying. Let me just read Acts chapter 4 in verse 23. On their release, Peter and John went back to their own people and reported all that the chief priests and the elders had said to them. When they heard this, they raised their voices together in prayer to God. Sovereign Lord, they said, you made the heavens and the earth and the sea and everything in them. You spoke by the Holy Spirit through the mouth of your servant, our father David. Why do nations rage and people plot in vain? The kings of the earth rise up and the rulers band together against the Lord and against his anointed one. Indeed, Herod and Pontius Pilate met together with the Gentiles and the people of Israel in the city to conspire against your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed. They did what your power and will had decided beforehand should happen. Now, Lord, consider their threats and enable your servants to speak your word with great boldness. Stretch out your hand to heal and perform signs and wonders through the name of your holy servant, Jesus. After they prayed, the place where they were meeting was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke the word of God boldly. How awesome is that? That's one of my favorite sections of passage. It was just flat out inspiring. They got together, they prayed, and the whole building shook. And it was amazing. And they spoke the word of God boldly. And that's what we need. We need prayers. We need to have deep prayers. We need to have community prayers. We need to have prayers by ourselves. And, you know, today I had a really great day. I had the opportunity to study the Bible with this young man who was an ex-pro boxer. And now he coaches or trains MMA. And I love it. You know, it's just awesome to see his heart for the scriptures. And Karabo joined us. And I thought I love this, you know, again, the community involvement. And Karabo works some weeks, off some weeks. So he had time to come. And so in the morning, we met at Mug and Bean. And we spoke about prayer. And we spoke about Luke 11. And let's go there in Luke 11. Because it's such an amazing prayer, and it's amazing to learn from Jesus, right? And so Jesus teaches this prayer, and we went over this prayer with the person we're studying the Bible with, and Karabo, and this is what Jesus says to them. He says, when you pray, say, Father, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, give us each day our daily bread, forgive us our sins, for we also forgive everyone who sins against us, and lead us not into temptation. And the person who's studying the Bible with, he's French speaking. So he reads his Bible in French and he translates in the moment, verse by verse, into English. And I just love it. Yeah, so he gave a perspective to these scriptures that are pretty amazing. And it starts with, Father, hallowed be your name. Honor your name, Lord, through the way we live. The next is your kingdom come. And I love the way he translated it. He said, God control us. that's the way it sort of fits within, with from French to English, I guess. And I thought that was such an amazing way of seeing your kingdom come. Help us to live under your reign and rule. Help us to be controlled by you, to choose you every second of the day. And as we continued on, you know, we just went verse by verse and translated from French to English. That was amazing. And we ended with prayer. And we spoke about corporate prayer. You know, and I just want to uplift Karabo for taking time to come through, Glenn, some of the other single men that are reaching out to him and building community. And this weekend, they're going to be away, you know, and they're going to have a lunch on Sunday and have him over, and another friend that we're reaching out to, and building community, building family. And so as we ended this lesson, I encouraged him, hey, pray with Karabo, pray with Glenn, pray with me, pray as a community, because these scriptures are not just about individuals going out by themselves and doing it. Individual, personal, private prayers are very important. No question about that. But it's also speaking to a community, the community that prays this prayer, like they did in Acts chapter 4, that is powerful. And then it was amazing because we ended the study and he says, Brother Raj, let me close out in prayer. I thought it was amazing, you know, that here we are in Mug and Bean, the three of us sitting at a table, and he prays for us in French. It was amazing. And, you know, and the only word I understood was amen. So when he said amen, I said amen. Well, it was awesome. It was amazing. And that's what we are. We are a family of all nations. We're a community of all nations, and we pray in all languages, and God understands all languages, you know, and that's so amazing. We worship a God who loves diversity, and we need to pray. We need to pray because what we have in front of us, the obstacles and challenges, are needing prayers. I'm not sure if you guys are following the news. I realize this is happening in America, but certainly even here, there's a lot of injustice. And my heart breaks to see young Black men being killed. It's terrible. It's absolutely terrible. There's no words to it. It makes me upset. It really makes me question a lot. It makes me angry, to be honest with you. It's ridiculous. We gotta pray. We gotta get on our knees. We gotta pray as a family, as a community, and say, Lord, bring justice into the world. Transform hearts. That's how this thing ends and this thing stops, is when people's hearts are transformed from within, to not see a person and say, I'm gonna kill this person because this person is Black, or this person is white, or this person is Indian, or this person is Asian, or this person is whatever. How is that going to change? It's through internal gospel transformation. And we pray as a family, as a community, Lord, transform our hearts, transform our minds. Help us to see all as your creation, as your image-bearing creation. All of us are God's children, all. But that's the problem, is that's not what people see. And so prayer, we need prayers. We're going through a pandemic. We need prayers. Lord, we need your intervention. Vaccine, no vaccine, I don't know what's going on, right? Recall this, recall that, I don't know what's going on. I think it's safe to say we're all just like taking one step, putting one step in front of the next, and we're just hoping and praying. But our prayers are not without effect. Our prayers are powerful because God hears our prayers. And we're praying for peace. We're praying for trusting in Him, not in us, not in each other, but in Him. And that we have to pray for this pandemic to end, and to bless our doctors and our and the scientists to have insight into things so they can provide the solutions, and to pray for our frontline workers and for them to have the energy and the wisdom and to pray for their families. We have to pray. We all have to pray. As a family, as a community. Because we desperately need prayers. And prayers work. Prayers are powerful. As we saw in the book of Acts, they prayed and the place shook. In fact, one of the things, as I study out early Christianity, I find so fascinating. And even as you read the book of Acts, which really captures the history of the early church, it's phenomenally amazing how the early church survived. If anything, the odds were stacked against them. Now, we read the book of Acts, and sometimes we don't see that. But honestly, when you read it carefully, and you see that this is a small movement that began with the simple claim that Jesus, who was crucified, is resurrected and is King of the universe. He is Lord and Messiah. And they took that message out from Jerusalem to Samaria, to the ends of the earth, to the known world, I guess. You know, they went into Roman territory. They went into places where Caesar is king. And they said, this is the truth. Yes, Jesus was crucified, but that's actually part of God's plan of rescue of all of humanity. So what was a Jewish faith was actually God's plan to use his people to bring in the whole world into his family. And so, yes, he was crucified, but Jesus rose from the dead and started new creation in the midst of the old. And so they went into cities and towns that had idols, that had Caesar worship, had all kinds of interesting things happening, not unlike today. And not only did they survive, they actually grew. And that again tells us prayer works. Prayer works. God is with us, and God wants us to engage with him in prayer. Not because he doesn't know what's happening with us. It's not like God's up there going, I don't know what's going on. Why don't you tell me, Raj, what's really going on? He knows our hearts. He wants us to engage with him. He wants us to rely on him. He wants us to trust in him. He wants us to say, hallowed be your name, honor you, Lord, and to honor him in our lives and our attitudes. And he wants us to come and to him and say, your kingdom come, may your will be done on earth as in heaven, in and through us today. He wants to hear from his children. He wants to connect with us. He says, come pray. And you see this young church, this fledgling church, and even as you read the book of Acts, you see all kinds of interesting things happen. There's stealing happening and all kinds of, you know, there's racial tension happening. And so this could split the church. And yet God brings this church together. God's church is still around today after 2,000 years, and God's church will always be around. His kingdom will never fall, and his kingdom includes the community of his people, the one family of all nations. Isn't that amazing? Great. So that's the midweek for today. Hopefully it's been an energizing time.
In your hands, Lord, I'm longing to see your desires revealed in me. I give myself away. Myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me.